So tetany can be mild and severe. Severe tetany is considered as an overt tetany. Okay, appo mild tetany undu adu pole thanne severe tetany, it can be considered as an overt tetany, OVERT, overt tetany. In mild tetany, there will be numbness and muscle spasm, tingling sensation, which is considering as paresthesia. But in severe tetany, what happens? It is otherwise considered as an overt tetany. What happens there? There will be chances to get a spasm in the respiratory muscles. It is characterized by laryngeal spasm. There will be bronchospasm, painful generalized muscle cramps, and later on the patient would end up with a seizure. Okay. Additionally, cardiac function is also impaired and it could cause arrhythmias. Fine. So, severe tetany is usually considering as an overt tetany. What happens in overt tetany? There will be chances to get a respiratory failure. At the same time, there will be chances to get a problem in a cardiac system as well. Okay, so this is usually expected in overt tetany. So, hypocalcemia, we have to focus more on hypocalcemia. Never leave the condition without giving proper treatment. Otherwise, what could end up with? There will be chances to get a life-threatened complications. Okay, so hypocalcemia complication is something very important. Clear? Fine.